Futures and options on futures trading involve substantial risk and is not a suitable investment for all types of investors. Past results are not necessarily indicative of future results. When I use the word I in this video, it refers to what I teach in my charting course or what I offer in my twice daily oral and written updates. Prices shown on charts and quote boards are in real time and take into account all known activity up to this point in time. And if you'd like
Good
to
morning.
Read more of this
Ira
disclaimer,
and
simply
Associates
hit the pause
with your morning
on your video
update.
Player.
And this is for Friday, the 8th of December, 2017, about 9:20 a.m. Central Standard Time. It's a day full of economic data, and I'll show it all to you. We've gotten the jobs data out today, and once again, we know that we're adding jobs, but there's no wage inflation, and that becomes the problem for this market. Now, even though the Fed is, I think it's a given that they're going to raise interest rates in December, I think you get questions about what happens March and the other months. And even though the Fed is talking three more hikes, how do they justify it becomes a question if you don't get inflation into the economy. Other economists see signs of inflation. I know it's the beginning of the year. You're going to get higher bills on God knows what, but they'll be coming out. So you always look at that. The stock market got a good bounce off the numbers, as you can see, off the early lows of the day. Now we'll see if the market can hold that the rest of the day. The VIX is pulling back, as you can see. Gold market continues under pressure, and even though it's only down 260, if you look at it, it was down nearly another $9. But we're seeing a little change here because stability has come in today to the silver market for a moment, and that's all I can say for a moment, whereas copper got a bit more, and copper got a bit of stability, as did a bit into the energies, because China's import-export numbers looked very, very good. So the economy's growing. China will now replace the U.S. as the world's largest importer of crude oil. And their numbers jumped rather sizably, and that gave the early rise. But it's not holding off of that rather dramatically. We're not going to import as much. They'll import. That's the wiggle that's going. But that's also why you're staying at $57 in the Jan. Now, remember, this contract goes off the board December 18th, but it's still the lead contract. Dollar a little higher today. I don't get financial TV. They're all telling me the British pound is higher. Either I'm blind, but it's not higher. It's down 59, and it's over a full cent off the morning high. Reality setting in there that now they have to move on to 1 year of trade talks. October 18th is when ideally the date will come together for the trade talks to end. But they have solved the situation of money. They've got the foreigners who are staying within the country, their rights established. They've got the open borders with Ireland settled today. So all those things now lead us to the really difficult road, and that road is going to be the trade talk. So we'll see, and there's going to be a lot of talk that Britain gave away everything to get out, but that was their goal. The vote was, do what you got to do. We want out of the EU for decades to come. All right, in the grain markets, we're still looking at markets under not any buying power. And you've got to keep your eye what's going on in Brazil. The real has taken a beating in markets that trade with that, like sugar markets, corn, soybeans. They don't respond well when you start seeing foreign currency, especially a country that produces as much of those products, their currency come under a lot of pressure. Let's go, if we could, at this point and take a look at what the data was today. Non-farm payrolls up good number, 228. Unemployment rate stayed right where it's at. I go right to the average hourly earnings, and you didn't get what you needed. They were looking for a bigger gain than that. On the year, you're up 2.5%. That's not very good. Chinese customs data, this is that piece of information that I was giving to you. It showed the import exports accelerated in November, and that's a good piece of news. We know the economy has been gradually slowing down, but when you look at these numbers, you wonder if the worst is behind them, because they're all pretty solid. I mentioned crude, and let's go to the bottom of this first. And as you can see, the data showed that their imports in November were up to over 9 million barrels a day, and that was up from 7.3 million barrels. And I'm telling you, at 9, they're replacing the U.S., at least on the data part of it. surging business in Japan during the third quarter pushed the economy up 2.5% on an annualized basis, and that was double what they expected there. So you get a little bounce in the yen, but nothing major right now. As I said, the UK and the European Union, they've reached 3 points of agreement now, big points. German Stats Bureau showed that for October, the imports were up 1.8% on the month, beating the expectations. Exports, though, were off 0.4, so that's not so good. Their trade surplus narrowed via that, and that makes sense. And housing starts in Canada were up 13.2% in a month. They've tried to stop that, and not doing a real good job of it, as I'm seeing. So let's see what the stock market does. We might be talking record high closes in the S&P if we get a little action here. Bitcoin will be in everybody's mind. It trades on Sunday night at the CBOE, and then the Merck gets it 10 days from today. They get their, I think it's December 18th, they're going to be starting their trading. And all the brokerage firms are scrambling not to just let it, but when they created the Bitcoin contract, prices were trading $800 probably to $3,000. You now hit nearly $20,000. Even at 35% margin, if you have 5 Bitcoins and it's back to 20, who can afford it at $50,000 margins? I think there's a mistake there. I'm Ira Epstein. You have yourself a good day, and I will talk to you all later today in my other videos.